Mary Waters to lead us in a moment of prayer.
Okay, let's bow our heads. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. Father, we thank you for the many good things that you send into our lives. Father, we thank you for this committee. We thank you for the help they give to our people. We just pray that you would be with us as we have this meeting and we hear reports and make our decisions. Be with us, Father, for we strive always to please you and make you proud of us as your children. Just be with us throughout all our days and help us. Be with us now. These things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Roll call.
Chairman Brooks?
Here.
Larry Joe Brooks, absent. John Sumner?
Here.
Nikki Michael?
Here.
Homer Scott?
Here.
Mary Waters?
Here.
And Verna Crawford here. We have four.
Kuba Mossy Hutch does not be open. When they she would be Kishku Sinkin Opening. I'm welcoming everybody here and thanking the Creator for this good spring day that's almost like summer. Do any of the tribal members have anything they would like to address the trust board about? I think that Cy Hughes has got some questions about the election rules, and she would like for the council and the trust board and any other interested parties to try to meet on the, I think you said the 29th, didn't you, Cy?
Yes, I'm going to be out on vacation. I'm leaving on Wednesday and I won't be back until the 18th to the 19th. But as we discussed, I was thinking about a workshop with the principals, which would be the council and membership, accounting, so I can develop a budget to submit for approval. And I just have some questions because we're trying to merge multiple documents.
Thursday, if I'm not mistaken.
The 29th is correct.
And that is the Thursday after the powwow on Memorial Day. So, is there any way? 29th.
Questions for me, anybody?
Well, she's coming back to that council, too.
Oh, yeah. That's my intention, is for you.
Thank you, Si. Can I hear a motion to approve the agenda? It's been moved and seconded to approve the agenda as presented. All in favor, say aye.
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 We need to back up just a second. At the last meeting, Doug told us he would not be here, and he requested that his absence be unexcused. Do we need to make a motion or just enter that into the record that it was unexcused?
I think it actually has to be entered into the record.
I'll move that Joe Brooks' absence today is unexcused.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Approval of minutes. Robert does have April 7th, March the 3rd, and March the 31st.
That should be March the 10th. I don't know where I can. That was, it was supposed to be then, and then that was all the money.
Did everybody, I've gotten my minutes right, everybody, but you've got a copy there. Do I hear further corrections to the March the 10th minutes? Since we've got three sets of minutes here, let's approve them. Can I entertain a motion to approve the March the 10th meeting minutes?
So moved. With corrections.
With corrections.
All in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Jan, did you have a question?
Well, I'm trying to see, you may have already corrected this on that March 7th. The very last line on the third page, it says your next meeting is April 7th. Does that mean March 7th? Or whatever?
No, this was the March meeting minutes. This was the March meeting minutes. Because I didn't have them last month.
Oh, okay.
So we're doing three sets of minutes tonight.
That's fine. It's
right.
And so I was clarifying if that's what they said or if that's what they sent her in the synopsis. And it doesn't sound like that's accurate.
So like I said, this was just examples. Then he goes on to explain other things. And
yeah.
Do I hear any further corrections to the March 31st special meeting minutes?
I'll move to approve the March 31st minutes with corrections.
May I hear a second? All in favor of the March the 31st minutes as special meeting minutes as corrected, please say aye.
Aye.
And finally, we go to the April the 7th regular April meeting in March.
On the last page at the top, look closely to make sure that's the correct wording for the resolution. Reviewing the minutes of April 7th. Yes. Is that where you were questioning in minutes?
Yes. Where it says drawdowns cannot exceed 4% of the trust earnings. And then it gets into what you can take out cannot exceed over 4% of what the trust earns. That's going to be a lot less money than what you're using now. 4% of, say, $100,000 is going to be $4,000.
Charlie, that's not what it means at all. Our interest over the last 7 or 8 years has only amounted to like 3.25%, 3.5%. I'm not sure about the exact figure, but that's close.
What we're talking about is drawdown, is that what you take out?
Well, we only, at the very most, we can only draw down what we made in interest. Unless a drawdown is actually a drawdown that is more than our budgeted amount, and we can't draw money down below 3.8 million without a vote of the people.
You're saying here that you're only going to draw down 4% of the trust earnings, and that's not going to be very much money, but you're going to operate on for years.
You're right. It does say earnings.
That's what was stated.
That would be $4,000 instead of $150,000 or $126,000. So the word in that resolution should be changed.
What is it today before the resolution? What we draw down?
Well, we get 10%, or we get all of the interest earnings divided among the committees at this time.
Okay, so this is going to knock out 96% of that.
That's not what we intended to do at all.
I didn't think so.
I think we might withdraw the resolution and bring it back to the table next month to clarify, because I went with what was said.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, because the percentages on stocks and bonds is not right.
Right, that's got to be redone anyway, so we need to just get a better understanding.
The earnings may have been the wording used in our best proposal, that what they meant was our total earnings, which was $127,000.
So the 4% is probably what's wrong.
Yeah.
It's wrong. I
think you see the problem.
Yeah. Yeah, there wasn't a stated percentage, but that's a percentage that they intend or hope to make, at least that much. In fact, they hope to make 5.5% or 6% instead of the 3.5% we have been making.
So the earnings is going to be 4%, not the 4% of the earnings.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, I think probably it would be a good idea for me to go down and talk to Scott and have him help me word that. If that would be acceptable to the board.
Be better than we do that.
Yeah.
Can I? Yes, Jan.
Well, I remember hearing something like this before out of Joe's mouth, and I didn't understand it, and I didn't say anything. But as long as it's not worth, like if the market fell and we didn't make anything, and it goes below our, what we already have, we can't lose more than 4% of that. That's not what they were saying. I'm
not sure that.
We'll find out and we'll figure it.
That's why I'm recommending we withdraw the, when it comes to approving that, I think we should withdraw it for clarification.
He did say, though, that even at their worst, like the examples he gave us of education endowment didn't even go below what we were making. We're making 3.36%. And even at their worst, when we hit rock bottom in 2010, they still didn't do as bad as we did.
Their paperwork shows that they're hoping to be looking at 5 or 5.5%, or maybe even 6% return. And we say, great, get it. But we're not going to use any more than 4% to start off. As it was actually intended. But I do agree with you. This needs to be reworded in a different way.
We've got a motion on the floor to approve the minutes first, and then your motion will go off. Yeah. Okay. The resolution would come back down here after the committee report.
Call for the question. The question's been called on the April the 7th minutes. All in favor of the minutes as corrected? Please say aye.
Aye.
There's no opposition to that. Okay. Treasurer's report, John Sumter. Community Services report, Barbara Crawford.
Community Services Committee met on April 14th. We received 24 applications for assistance. We declined one. We had one pending more information, and we approved 22. And our next meeting will be next Monday. On the 12th, starting 1 p.m. with Education and Community Services on the same time.
the Culture Preservation Committee, as always, still meets on the third Tuesday of every month. That'll be the 20th of this month. And that's 2 days before the powwow starts. We still plan to have language classes starting back up again shortly after powwow. And I believe the chief, Jan Brown, or is it every Tuesday night, chief, that y'all are doing crafts?
Until powwow, yes.
Until the powwow? Okay.
That's going craft class, yeah.
Will it stop afterwards?
I don't know, but we'll have to decide. We're just trying to get ready for powwow.
Education Committee, Nikki Michael.
We met April 14th, and I'd like to thank Bonnie, our vice, for handling that meeting. I was in Fort Lauderdale at NQUA. Life was rough. Actually, we approved 9 applicants, and 2 are pending for a total of $476.25. Our next meeting is May 12th in conjunction with Community Services. And at our next meeting, we're going to be talking about raising money for our scholarship. And it's starting this summer, so we're going to kick off a campaign drive to raise money. Any questions?
What time
is the money? 1 o'clock.
Quickly. Yes, ma'am. Do you know that when they ended the Monterey, were earning money for you guys for the education?
No, thank you. Is that the
we had 1 month was elder nutrition, and from then on we switched it over to education. And you at least got 200 something last month.
First Wednesday of each month. Everybody go eat at Monterey.
Be sure and get your coupon out off the web.
Yeah, you have to have your coupon.
Oh,
I sure didn't want a party, but I'm not sure I'm going to do that.
I'll tell you then.
Oh, people in Delaware.
Target's 20.
Yes.
I find.
So I don't know
when everybody's going. Chief, could we make copies of the coupon and distribute them tomorrow at lunch?
We can.
And to all the employees to make sure people have them?
We have a few now, but I mean, Sandy does that.
Great.
That is this coming Wednesday night. Somebody told me they're even having 55% margaritas down there.
Oh, no.
Wouldn't know.
Committee, Mary Waters.
Okay. The committee met today at 12:45 p.m. And we report that in April the elders visited Forest Manor and Journey Home Hospice. And then on April the mothers, war mothers, and veterans participated in unveiling the Veterans Wall of Honor. And then April 29th, the owners went to Muskogee to see the azaleas at Honor Heights Park, had lunch at Amish Bakery, and a stop on the way home for Brahms ice cream. Elders voted to remember elders that had passed from our group by adding to the Delaware Memorial Gardens in Barbersville. A donation of $100 will be given to the 50th annual Delaware powwow. And then to honor Judy Dahl and Arlena Wittenberg, the elders will give them $50 each. The elders were invited by Bonnie Jo Griffith to go with Oklahoma Indian Summer Committee to visit Red Buffalo Ranch in Sedan, Kansas, May the 10th.
Thank you, Mary. John, do you have a reinvestment report other than the...
No, it's already been covered. Other than that, no report.
And the tribal operations, Joe Brooks is absent. I did see on the internet starting Friday that Cherokee Chief Bill John Baker has through their Attorney General Chuck Austin has sent a letter supporting our tribe move back to Kansas. I don't know, perhaps the chief or Jan Brown would like to comment on that. I mentioned it because I actually think that we've had a great chance since Bill John Baker got elected. He has been very cooperative with our tribe, and we've been able to get some programs that we wouldn't have got under his predecessor. So that's good news. Yes, Charles.
The Cherokee Washington County Cherokee Association or group met last week, and they gave a presentation on how the Delaware landed in the middle of the Cherokees. And I went to wondering what that's really going to be. But it's really a positive report, a positive outlook of how the Cherokee, how the Delaware got down here. So I didn't know what they were going to report. I was just curious what the group.
Did we get it on film?
I don't think so.
Yes, Bob.
I can also report that Bill John Baker is going to be the honorary powwow chair at Indian Summer. And we'll be there Thursday, Friday, Saturday nights. We'll be having an honor dance for him on Saturday, I believe. And he'll be spending some time. He'll be spending some time playing Cherokee marbles with the kids and stuff on Friday afternoon. So due to a large donation that the Cherokees gave to us, we felt the need to do something to honor him. So he will be We'll be having an honor dance, like I said, Saturday for him.
That's at our powwow?
No, that's at Oklahoma and Summit.
Okay, what are the dates?
September 18th through the 21st. Thursday night is a reception for Bill Curtis and an Indigenous free concert. Friday will be the art market powwow. Saturday will be the art market. We're going to have a kids' fair this year and powwow. Sunday, we've invited in a bunch of the youth groups to come and do different offerings to judge. And so far, I think we, the Cherokee Children's Choir, is that what it is called? They've entered, and a couple others. So I don't know, Nikki, you might want to call Lori about Lenobiosi. Her number's on all of our information, so.
Bonnie, would you email me a summary of what you just said so that I can make sure I quote it right?
Okay.
Well, you know,
I know
what the events are. I don't want to misquote.
Okay.
Thank you.
So after 147 years of hard times in the Cherokee Nation, now we're going to get to shoot marbles with their chief.
Well,
only if you're a kid.
We're all kids at heart.
You ever see how the Cherokee marbles grow?
Good, John.
Veterans Committee, Homer Scott.
Yes, our next Veterans Committee is next week, May 14th at 6 o'clock on Wednesday. And on the Vet Flags Committee with John Sumter as a veteran. Bonnie Jo Griffin as a war mother, and Charles Randall as the elder in charge of doing that parish. And they've done a great job, and I want to thank them for what they've done.
Thank you. I think everybody here has already seen the veteran picture, right? And I understand that they've got some more new pictures that need to be framed. Look through the lines.
We've got probably 12 to 15 new ones, but this side can hold 5 more, and that side can hold 30 more. So we're going to get them all restructured and start adding the new ones.
So we don't leave that alone. It is important to know the unfinished business we had. The resolution on the investment strategy. And I think there's a motion coming to table for clarification. Do I hear a second? All in favor of withdrawal of resolution 2014-2, would say aye.
Aye.
New business. Is there any new business to come before the trust board? new business.
I'll move to set the date and time of the next meeting to be 4 p.m. June 2nd here at the community center.
Motion's been made that the next meeting will be at 4 p.m. on June the 2nd here at the Bartlesville Community Center. I hear a second.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
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 And I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
I second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Don't forget the Delaware Power.